My patient Raju, a 7-year-old boy from Agra, student of class 1, presented with chief complaints of a split in the lip on the left side since birth and opening in the roof of the mouth towards left side since birth. Patient was born with a split in his upper lip on the left side and an opening in the roof of the mouth towards left side. It was associated with a difficulty in suckling as an infant and child, difficulty in speech and articulation, and frequent episodes of fever, cough and sore throat. There were history of similar complaints, that is just an opening in the roof of the mouth only, in the younger sister as well. There were no history of similar complaints in parents or other family members. No history of maternal smoking or alcohol use, especially during the antenatal period. No maternal history of anti-epileptic, anti-acne or any other drug use. No maternal history of antenatal folic acid supplementation. Something I missed here, maternal age was 26 years when the child was born. On examination, the patient was examined in sitting position in a well-lit room after taking due consent from the parents. Patient's height is 121 centimeters, weighing 23 kgs. Body mass index is 15.7, all falling within the normal range of a 7-year-old. Performance status is KPS 90. Patient is adequately nourished and hydrated. Patient's pulse rate is 88 per minute. Respiratory rate is abdominal thoracic 14 per minute. Blood pressure 106/72, afebrile. No pallor, icterus, cyanosis, pitting edema, or generalized lymphadenopathy. In local examination, the oral hygiene is average. There is a unilateral complete cleft on the left side of the upper lip, extending into the nasal floor. Flattened nasal ali on the left side and nasal septum deviated to the right side. Cleft is present in the alveolus on the left side. The defective dentition, malocclusion of teeth present. Unilateral cleft on the left side of the palate involving the soft and hard palate. Difficulty in pronunciation of fricatives, no ear discharge. Here is an examination of the cleft lip, it is on the left side. This is the cleft palate, it involves the alveolus here, soft palate is involved here, and then the hard palate is involved. Systemic examination is normal, per abdomen there was no palpable lumps, external genitalia is normal, no endorectal malformation. My summary is, a 7-year-old boy with left-sided unilateral complete cleft lip with left-sided unilateral complete cleft palate involving the alveolus, hard palate and soft palate.
Okay, nicely presented.
Thank you, sir.
What is the classification system for cleft lip and palate, you knowing? It could be unilateral, it could be bilateral,
sir, yes,
it could
be cleft partial. Cleft lip can be unilateral or bilateral.
Yeah.
It can be central or lateral.
Mm-hmm.
It can also be complete or incomplete.
And it also, you can start from lip, Lassalle classification.
Sir. So we use a Lassalle classification. It's a method of basically describing the problem in which we use letters L for lip, A for alveolus, H for hard palate, S for soft palate. And then we extend to the other side as well to denote if there is a bilateral cleft. In case of a complete cleft, we will use a capital letter. In case of a small cleft, we'll use a small letter. In case of incomplete cleft. And H is used only once because hard palate, the cleft in the hard palate is generally in the midline, sir.
Okay. And individually, this hard palate and soft palate, it is can be classified into complete and incomplete kind of thing.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And similarly, the lip also can be classified into partial and
complete. Yes, sir. Depending upon if the cleft is going up till the nostril or not, sir.
What is the minimum age of treatment of this cleft lip?
Okay, first the history part or examination. Anything else in the examination that you did?
Okay. Who's the informant? Did you tell us?
Who was the informant?
My mother is the informant. Yes.
Anything with the position of the teeth and the mandible? Yes.
The dentition is defective. The premaxilla was slightly protruded outwards. And there is also malocclusion of teeth present, sir.
Are they important when you describe the... Because the examination is complete.
Yes,
it's not just the lip and the palate. How about the uvula? It's not split?
No, sir.
Where is it?
It is not seen.
It's not been captured here, sir.
So we needed tongue depressor to see that. Is it necessary to know?
Yes, sir. to know if it is if there is submucous cleft sometimes present.
Or how much of palate is involved? So is it complete?
Alveolus is involved, soft palate and hard palate is involved.
Okay, doctor, you can proceed, doctor. Dr. Sena.
What is the minimum age of surgery? Because there is nothing more to examine here. Everything is.
What do you do to these patients?
Sir, I like to.
This patient has come to you. Yes. Now, what do you do? You don't operate tomorrow, so no, you do something. What do you do?
Sir, this patient, the minimum age has to be 10 weeks for operation.
That's for lip or palate?
For lips, sir. Millet's criteria, sir.
Rule of 10.
Rule of 10.
It
sir.
Still works? Does it still work, doctor?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, the minimum age has to be 10 weeks. Hemoglobin has to be minimum 10. TLC has to be less
and
than
weight?
10,000. And weight has to be more than 10 pounds.
Pounds?
Pounds, yes.
Why was that criteria set? It's fitness only. They didn't have, this is performance status assessment in these patients. What else? This patient has got palate also. There's some problem, no? Because patient will not be, if it is cleft lip alone, it's okay.
Yes, sir.
Would the decision change if there is a palate as well as lip?
So the child is in 7 years old. So
suppose this was younger. 7 years, you don't have, you are already late.
So in case of an infant.
What's the optimum age for this, he asked you? Lip? You said rule of 10. For palate?
Sir, say if in such a case, if an infant presents with us the same problem, we like to operate between 15 to 18 months of age, sir.
No, because this is a neglected age. You
yes,
must
sir.
Know about the classical age.
Yeah, that's why I'm asking.
This is a neglected case of cleft lip and palate.
Right ages, you said? 18 months.
Yes, sir, 15 to 18.
Why 18?
Sir, we have to do a two-stage surgery in this case, sir. In an infant.
Does it have anything to do with speech?
Sir, yes, sir. That is the time when the speech is being, the child will only start speaking.
It is, I think it is 1 year to walk and 2 years to talk.
Yes, sir. Frigatives.
So,
the child will start using frigatives only after 18 months of age, sir. That's why we do it.
Very good.
That's why I've asked you this question.
Yes.
It is relevant even today.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Dr. Sina.
And if a baby of 2 month old or 3 month old with a cleft lip and palate come to you,
yes, sir.
What other advice you will give to the parents? Because you are not going to operate that cleft palate till 1.5 years.
Yes, sir.
Till that time, what problem the baby and the family face?
Sir, the child is going to face difficulties in suckling. So, we can tell the parents to use a modified larger teat for him to be able to suckle on. Certain feeding specialists also recommend using an obturator to discontinue the continuity between the oral and the nasal cavities.
Mm-hmm.
So that can also allow help the child in feeding.
What is the major advantage of that obturator? It's not just this.
So even
what will happen if the food goes?
Nasal regurgitation is also prevented by obturators.
So basically, it's not just for one part that you mentioned.
Yes,
okay.
And also advise them feeding in sitting posture, because the feed will go down with the help of gravity.
Yes, sir.
Because they are not having
the respiration. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Yes. If the child is having respiratory
basically
problem.
If you aspirate, there are issues, so you need to be careful.
And also tell them regarding chances of recurrent ear infections also, because
yes,
in
yes.
those kind
his
of...
His patient tube is left non-patent
yeah.
because of involvement of the tensor villi palatini and the levator villi palatini. So this child can have otitis media frequently.
So what do you do? It's lip and palate both, sir. Neglected. It's 8 years old baby.
Yes, sir.
This is what
sir,
Dr.
Sina
was asking.
Sir, in an 8 year old child, I will try to complete this, treat him and operate the patient in one sitting if it is possible. And otherwise, I can operate him in two sittings. In case of a two sitting operation, in the first sitting, we'll be operating upon the lip and the soft palate first. And then later on, we can be operating on the hard palate.
Okay.
I would like to...
Can you enumerate for us the deformities that need to be corrected
yes,
here?
Sir.
The components of deformities
and
that have to be
corrected. Here, we have to correct the cleft lip by Millard's advancement.
Don't tell the procedure. Cleft lip, cleft is there, but what all needs
yes,
to be corrected?
Cleft lip needs to be corrected.
Tell
here,
the anatomical parts
yes,
of the lip.
Alveolus is also affected here, so that needs to be taken care of. Hard palate is there
so
and soft
let's
palate
talk
is there.
About the lip. Now you have to measure the segments, no?
Yes,
how
ma'am.
Much part is there on each side. Then there is clumping and hypertrophy
yes,
at
ma'am.
The edges that needs to be seen.
Yes.
There is shortening of columella. You
yes,
have to
that's
take
yeah.
a look about that.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Then there is widening of the ala nasi. You have to see that the two pillars of the ala nasi should be brought together.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. This child can
also
be.
Talk about all these components. Tell us some more.
Ma'am, since after since this, we can see that nasal septum is divided to the non-cleft
side.
Where
is columella?
Columella.
Columella is the base of the center of the.
Where is it gone?
It's gone towards the non-cleft side, sir.
And there is, it has to be brought there.
Yes, sir.
Hmm? Is it shortened? Usually get shortened. You can see the.
Because the skin is being retracted towards the lateral side.
Flattened.
Flattening of the ala on the cleft side.
So the columella gets shortened. Okay. Right. Other deformities. 3-4 she has already rattled out.
We can see that this, there is a little protrusion of the premaxilla outside, outwards. And dentition is missing here. The canine.
Why do you think this premaxilla is projecting?
Sir, because the forces that were supposed to hold it back on one side is absent. Had it been a case of bilateral cleft, this would have been even more prominent.
Right.
And might have been accompanied with a prolabium as well.
So deviated nasal septum has to be corrected,
yes,
along with it.
Can, yes,
and
it
plus the alar cartilages need to be repositioned.
Yes, ma'am. After completing a surgery for lip and palate, we can consider this child for an open septorhinoplasty, if possible.
At a second later stage. So you'll do lip and palate together, or you just do the lip first?
Sir, in the book for an infant, it said that lip and.
No,
soft
not an infant here.
Yes,
infant, you okay? Tell
sir,
us. In
they
the
said lip and soft palate have to be done before, and then hard palate. But I consult the plastic surgeons. I consulted. They said that they can do it in one sitting as well.
What do the pediatric surgeons say?
Yes, we are not operating this. It is operated by plastic surgeons.
You're sending to plastics, okay? So they say in one stage they can do it.
Yes, sir.
What's the problem with one stage?
Sir, there is extensive dissection because of a longer surgery. Because of that, scarring can take place and the palatal growth gets affected, maxillary growth.
See, when we trained, we did all these. I mean, these are not very cumbersome rocket science procedures. So you should understand, and I am happy you mentioned the forces that are pulling it away are responsible for projecting it upwards.
Yes,
this needs to be corrected because in spite of whatever you do, there would be soft tissues not going to stay in that position. And you will not get the cosmetic and functional outcome.
Yes, sir.
You won't get oral competence at the end of it. You get my point?
Yes, sir.
Now, so
tell us something which needs to be fractured before you repair the hard palate.
Now comes the fracture.
The soft palate.
What
has, something has to be fractured, no, in that bone. What is that?
Ma'am,
what do you call this fracture of a bone that you do yourself? Osteotomy is only, you know.
Yes, osteotomy.
So you don't cause, you otherwise you don't splinter it. You give it into a particular. Okay. What do you do?
Ma'am, in here the palatine bone osteotomy.
No, palatine bone is itni badi. Which part of palatine bone? So the hook of the hammet has to be broken. You have to literally break it with the hand.
And then you drag. Then that's you when you can bring it down.
Then you
that's
can bring the mucus.
It is one of the steps we do for
yes.
the intravillar veloplasty.
You yes, you,
yes.
That's what the same procedure. Exactly the same.
Yes.
Hook of the hammet is broken and you drag it down.
Sir.
And then you have to hold it in that place.
Yes, sir.
It is not, it's going to go back because the spring coil effect, it keeps going back. And what do you do? How do you repair the lip? Okay, let's get to your comfort zone now.
Sir, we can use the Millard's rotation advancement flap technique. And there are other techniques like Tennyson Z-plasty and quadrilateral flap.
Is there any particular type that you would use for bilateral versus unilateral?
I'm sorry, sir.
Okay. Tennyson for bilateral mostly. Millard they were doing for unilateral.
Yes,
Millard is commonly done. They can do anything with Millard. That's what plastic surgeons say, and you
yes,
must
sir.
Have met some of them. What did they say they are going to do here?
Sir, they told me that here they have to give it in Millard's technique. They'll be using a slightly convex incision going from the margin of the cleft up till the columellar base, and that length will be determined by the length of the philtrum on the normal side. So
all right. So what exactly is Millard based on?
Sir, it's a rotation advancement flap technique in which there is one rotation flap is used and another advancement flap is used. The rotation flap is.
How do you measure its length?
Sir, the principle behind it is that the length vertical distance from the nose to the lip in the normal side is going to be used as the vertical distance on the cleft side as well.
Right.
That is the principle. And there we have to ensure that Cupid's bow is maintained. So the two higher parts which are supposed to be somewhere here, have to be at the same length. That's what we're trying to achieve. So the rotation flap is made by a convexity from the base of the columella to the cleft margin, and the advancement flap is basically cutting just below the nostril in transverse fashion, sir, slightly upwards.
It becomes a Z-plasty at one point, and that is also a method to do that.
Yes,
it's
sir.
Not the Z that you classically see, it's at angle.
Angle, sir, yes.
In how many layers do you stitch this lip when you stitch it up? And which layer do you stitch first, the cutaneous or the
mucosa? How many first?
How
many layers are there?
So there's the outer.
No, tell us the layers, not total number of layers in which you stitch the lip. You must be doing lip lacerations also, no?
I'm sorry, I never operated on the lip before.
I'm glad you never did, because you don't know how to do it.
Sir, we use a...
But what are the layers there?
Three layers are there, outer skin, the inner skin and the...
Inner skin?
The mucosa, the outer skin, sir.
So mucosa,
and what is in between?
There's
a muscle in between.
So three layers, we do it in 3 layers. And same, we do the 3 layers for my palate as well.
And you start with the skin or the inner layer? Common
sense.
Inner
layer, sir.
If you start with skin, what will happen? You won't see the inner layer. But you can lift it up and do the inner one. The advantage will be then advancement. You cannot adjust. No. I'm not joking. It's a serious question.
So once you start stitching this...
Then you know how much to cheat on either side.
Yes, sir.
To cut it or to extend it. So it's not always perfect with that measurement. Therefore, you close the inner layer first. Even in when you're doing commandos and reconstructing cheek, you do the same thing. You first do the inner layer and then see how much you need to mobilize and how much you need to extend. Where you don't have to cut the mucosa, you just have to cut the skin and muscle and you can advance it. So therefore, we start from inside out.
And when you start stitching the skin, you have to stitch the vermilion border first.
Yes, ma'am.
So white roll in the vermilion border have to be kept in mind.
For the palate?
So palate first, we also, the intravillar veloplasty, we do it in 3 layers. First, the nasal mucosa. Once we open this...
Can you just suture it?
So the nasal mucosa will...
What do you do? What advancement is done here?
Sir,
cleft palate repair, I'm asking. Yes. Forget the lip now, just the palate.
Sir, we will... In case of soft palate, the muscles have to be mobilized and then restructured.
So,
and
which vessels you encounter here? These are also transposition flaps, no?
Yes, sir.
Based on which vessels? Which artery is supplying the palate?
Palatine artery.
So, you should have read about it. And you will have to sacrifice at one point, but based on the other one, you can mobilize it. You give release on either side, and then that you leave packed, and this is mobilized completely, and there is a periosteum elevator of the palate which is available, which is at an angle. You can just clear it on either side, you suture in the middle, and pack on sides. That's
yes.
How you close the midline defect.
Yes. Oh,
I thought you would have read about
it. I did, sir, actually. So we subperiosteal, we do dissection to mobilize the muscles and then we suture them in the midline, sir. We try to create a new margin, sir.
If these patients, especially the 8-year-old neglected one, it'll be difficult because compliance is limited.
Yes, sir.
So they have a tough time. You have a tough time to break not just the hook of hand. You just break the hook and you think it will come down, it will not. You may have to do osteotomy, you will have to cut some more bone.
Sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
And finally, patient comes sometimes after a week or 2 weeks with a hole, which you have done everything but that remains. But you can continue to use that obturator and it heals after a while.
Sir.
Can we close? Thank you. Give him a round of applause.
Thank you, sir.